the sarpanch is concerned, I feel sad for him. He doesn't know the meaning of the word development. He has not done anything, the basic that he could have done, the most that he could have done, something that had to be done immediately is the panchayat ghar. Okay? He was the sarpanch for 3 years. He did nothing. The only thing they did, he did along with his mentor, is, you know, lay the foundation stone for the panchayat ghar inside the office. Once at Queeninagar and once, I think, at Daboli. Okay? But where is the panchayat ghar? Okay? How long are the people going to wait? Finally, the panchayat had to move away from this building, and now they are housed in 2 flats along the road, causing so much traffic problems there. Is this called responsibility? The only thing I think the sarpanch of Sangwal knows is to hold beauty contests. Miss Kortali and Mr. Kortali. I don't know what this means, you know. Is this development according to his reasoning? Very sad. Very, very sad. Another thing I would like to tell you about the sarpanch. I challenged the sarpanch also. What work has he done during his tenure as the sarpanch? Nothing. Absolutely nothing. I know he's been inaugurating some gutters. I think even those works were done by Ramakant, Vorka. Okay? He's the one who moved the files for those works, and he's inaugurating them now. What has he done? Nothing. So he's just like his mentor. His mentor was in Kortaling constituency for 20 years, has nothing to show to his credit. And because I have done so many major projects that people can see with their eyes. People are thanking me time and again. And now during the campaign, when I go to meet people, people say, Madam, tum bina ka tu en zayate kela. And that is my reward. Okay? I have worked hard and I'm here to work, because when we take up this responsibility of being the MLA of the constituency, it is to ensure that people's needs are met with. This is the road that we worked for. Today the road is being hot mixed. I'm just standing there as an observer and to express my joy that a basic infrastructure, a very much essential infrastructure for the people of the area is happening.
Madam, in the last few years, we have taken up a lot of work, but there are some occasions that, probably you've not done anything more.
Yes, I think that makes me laugh, Actually, what they talk gives me enough reason to have a good laugh, because those adults who are talking and, making up stories, they are either, blind, or they are total liars. I'm sorry to make this statement, because everybody can see the works I have done are there for everyone to see. And people know. Wherever I go, people say, Madam, tu en zayate kela. Ani, this ex-MLA of Kortaling constituency, I have challenged him. He has not yet met with my challenge. I challenged him to show one work that he has done during his tenure of 20 years. Of course, the only white elephant that he had created is the Kala Bhavan, which is now happening and is still going on, and I took up the work. I was refusing to take up the work. You know why? Because Kala Bhavan was started without a parent department. Every project, when it is started, it is done under a parent department. This project had no parent department. And that is why it took us almost 1.5 years to find somebody. And then nobody wanted to take the responsibility. Even Kala Bhavan, the similar work that was going on over there. But to do this project, we need land. And at that time, if I'm not mistaken, Ramakant Borkar was the chairperson of the Kumnidad. And we asked him for land. And he promised the land. He meant well, I'm sure he meant well, because he took us, he showed us the site, he told us how much land he would give, but finally there was no actual, you know, what should I say, papers moved to give us the land. Now, unless I have the land, can I do it? The land has to be either Kumnidad land or some private land. We did our best to get the land so that we could construct housing for the inhabitants of Zuarinagar, and we would be constructing vertical. See, the goal was to, even in Pune, it's the same principle followed. They construct vertical so that they can vacate land from the migrants or from those who have occupied the land, and it's a win-win situation for the owner of the land and also for the people, because people get well-planned houses, okay, maybe not huge but good enough, better than what they have, and the land is vacated for the owner. Unfortunately, even another issue I have to say, at that point of time, even Mr. Anand Bose intervened and he tried to talk to some of the landowners, but even he did not succeed to get the land. Now, unless I get the land, I could not do anything. In fact, we spoke to the Kumnidad, we tried to explain to the Kumnidad, look, if you give us the land and allow us to construct vertical, go upwards, then we can vacate your land, take away those who have invaded your land and give back a major part of your land. But somehow it did not happen. Now, without the land, I cannot do anything about it. But let me tell you, I am now with Aam Aadmi Party. Now, this is a party that is focused on the common man. And I have full faith that once we come to power, this will be one of our main goals, to provide proper housing for the people of Zuarinagar, because all of us are children of God and all of us have the right to have decent living conditions. And I am very sure that our head, that is Sir Kejriwal, he will be doing his best to ensure that this project becomes a reality.
काम चालू आहे मॅडम, इन प्रोजेक्ट तिने पास करून आणलं आणि तो आता आमच्या गावात केजीच्या गावात तो हॉटमिक्स बी करून मॅडम आयली असा आणि त्याचे आता इनॉग्रेशन जातले. तिका आम्ही काळजून त्यांनी देव बरे करू म्हणटा, कित्याक तिने हो फॉलोअप केलो देखून.
Very good response, because people, I explained to the people what is happening in Delhi. And I would like to tell all of you that when I joined Aam Aadmi Party, I did not do it on the spur of the moment. I went to Delhi. I tried to meet people. I went to the houses. I spoke to the people. I spoke to the teachers, I spoke to doctors, because I went to see the health clinics, I went to see the schools, I went to the houses, I spoke to the people, I asked them, is it really true that you're getting free electricity, free water? They said yes. I said, can you show me any evidence of that? They came out with their, you know, bills which showed zero unit consumption. So when I was convinced that whatever is being announced as work of Aam Aadmi Party, it is a reality. And that is when I was satisfied that I was doing the right thing by joining Aam Aadmi Party. Who would be watching what is happening? I have not come here. I'm not inaugurating the road. I'm not breaking any coconuts. I'm just here because I'm happy that another work of mine is becoming a reality today.